Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. Today we will discuss reflex klystron, its applicate diagram and the operation of reflex klystron. So this is the structure of reflex klystron. It consisting of a single cavity where the RF output is taken. So this is the cathode which is given a negative voltage of minus V0. So this is called, generally called as cathode voltage. So the electron beam is accelerated because of this anode towards this gap. See, the DC beam electron velocity is initially V0. Once it passes through this cavity gap, this is called as cavity. Once it passes through this cavity gap, it is subjected to velocity modulation. So which is represented as V of T1. So there is a repeller. So this region is called as repeller space. So this repeller is given a negative voltage of VR. So due to this repeller voltage, the electron is repelled. That means the electron will never reach the repeller. The electron is again forced back into the cavity gap again. So this is the general, let us see the what is the operation of this reflex klystron. The operation of reflex klystron is very simple. So that depends upon the RF voltage here. So when the RF voltage across the gap is zero, the electron beam travels with unchanged velocity. When the gap voltage is positive, when the RF voltage across the gap is positive, the electron beam gets accelerated. Then when the gap voltage is negative, when the RF voltage across the gap is negative, the electron beam gets decelerated. So based on this, the velocity modulation occurs. So let us see one by one this operation of this reflex klystron. See, number one, it is a O-type original or linear beam tube. So as it is comes into the category of O-type tubes or linear beam tubes. The magnetic field is used to focus the electron beam as it travels along the tube. See, the purpose, it is called as O-type tube or original type tube or linear beam tube. So the purpose of magnetic field is here to focus the electron beam as it travels from cathode to the repeller. That's why it is called as linear beam tube. Next, number two, it is used as an oscillator at microwave frequencies. Basically, this structure works as an oscillator which generates frequencies in the microwave frequency range. Next, number three, it is assumed that the oscillations are set up in the tube initially due to noise or switching transients, which is represented as Vs is equal to V1 sin omega t. See, initially the RF voltage across this gap is set initially because of switching transients or noise. So because of the switching transients or noise, so initially the RF voltage is set up across the gap. So it is represented initially with Vs is equal to V1 sin omega t. Now, the electron beam injected or emitted from the cathode is first velocity modulated by the cavity gap voltage. As explained, because of this cavity gap voltage, the electron gets velocity modulated. So let us see. In this case, in 5, 6 and 7 points, we consider 3 electrons, early electron, reference electron and late electron. Let us see what happens with early electron, reference electron and late electron in the coming discussion. So let us see this one. The early electron, which is represented with E suffix E, early electron that passes through the gap before the reference electron, experiences a maximum positive voltage across the gap, and this electron, what happens to the electron? This electron gets accelerated. It moves with greater velocity and penetrate deep into the repeller space. The return time for this electron EE is greater as the depth of penetration into the repeller space is more. Let us see this electron EE in the applicate diagram. So this is called as applicate diagram. You can see this is called as applicate diagram of a reflex klystron, very very important diagram. So this is the RF voltage across this gap. So this is the voltage across this gap. So this is the time across time axis. So this is the positive half cycle. What positive half cycle we have written is the electron beam is accelerated during this half cycle. So the electron beam gets accelerated during this half cycle, positive half cycle. See, during this negative half cycle, the electron beam decelerated during this half cycle. During negative half cycle, the electron beam gets decelerated. So this is the voltage across this gap. So first, what is this? Let us consider three electrons, EE, early electron, reference electron, and late electron. Now coming to the discussion of early electron. So at early electron, so the what is the gap voltage? The gap voltage is maximum positive. So because of the maximum positive voltage, what will happen? The electron beam gets accelerated. This electron gets accelerated due to maximum positive voltage across the gap. This electron gets accelerated. So because of this, you can see this repeller space. So it travels deeper into the repeller space. See that it will penetrate more into the repeller space because of negative voltage to the repeller. It again comes back towards the cavity gap again. So this is early electron path is shown like this. So it is traveled deeper into the repeller space due to negative potential to the repeller. It is again reflected back towards the cavity gap. So this is shown like this. Let us come to this reference electron now, second one. The reference electron ER that passes through the gap when the gap voltage is zero gets unaffected by the gap voltage. This moves towards the repeller and gets reflected by the negative voltage of the repeller. See here, what is ER? For this reference electron, what is the RF voltage across the gap? The RF voltage across this gap zero. So what happens? This electron will travel with unchanged velocity. Therefore, it will travel less deeper. When compared with this electron, it will travel less deeper into the repeller space. Due to the negative voltage given to the repeller, it again comes back towards the cavity gap again. So this is what for the reference electron. Let us see the late electron EL. See, the late electron EL that passes through the gap later than the reference voltage, reference electron, experiences a maximum negative voltage and moves with a retarding velocity. The return time for this electron is shorter as the penetration into the repeller space is less and it catches up with the early reference electron and the early electron, and this results forming bunch centered around the reference electron. Let us see the third one, very important point again. For this electron, late electron, what is the gap voltage? The gap voltage is maximum negative. So because of this maximum negative voltage, the electron beam gets retarded or the velocity of the electron gets reduced. So therefore it will travel even less into the repeller space. Because of negative voltage, it will come back again into the towards cavity gap. So therefore these three electrons, early electron, reference electron and late electron, gets combined and they will form into the bunches. So this is represented as electron bunch. The question is here that when should this electron beam reach to the cavity gap so that maximum kinetic energy of this electron beam is transferred to the cavity gap. So let us see in the coming point. So here, this is the very very important point. So this point is very very important. In order for the electron beam to generate maximum amount of energy for oscillations, the returning electron beam must cross the cavity gap when the gap volt field is maximum retarding. In this way, a maximum amount of kinetic energy can be transferred from the returned electrons to the cavity walls. So this is what the very very important point. Let us see this in this diagram. So what happens? The electron beam is returning back. So the electron beam is returning back. So the electron beam is returning back. Once it finds the maximum retarding voltage, once it finds the maximum retarding voltage across this gap, so that it means because of this minus sign here, plus sign here, this returned electron beam, when it encounters maximum retarding fields, so therefore that maximum kinetic energy of this electron beam, the maximum kinetic energy of this electron beam is transferred to this cavity gap. So therefore, it starts producing oscillations. So therefore, when this electron beam should cross this gap? When the gap voltage is maximum positive. So because of this, it will become the retarding, maximum retarding field for this electron beam. So let us see in this diagram, the same thing in this diagram. You can see this. So this is the reference electron. This is one cycle. This is one cycle. So this is 3/4 cycle. So here is the maximum positive voltage across the gap. That means this is the maximum retarding field for the electron bunch. So therefore, this is one cycle, this is 3 by 4 cycles. So therefore, this is called as 1 3by 4 mode. So because of this 1 3 by 4 mode, so therefore the this point you can see this are this cycle, the returned electron beam is retarded during this half cycle. Because of this is positive half cycle, the electron beam is returning back. So during this half cycle, this electron beam encounters retarding field. So this is all about this 1 3 by 4 mode. So why this is 1 3 by 4 mode? This is one cycle, so this is 3 by 4 cycle. So this is 1 3 by 4 cycle. At this point, the electron beam transfers maximum kinetic energy to the cavity walls. So let us discuss next one. The bunch occurs once per cycle. So there will be one bunch will be formed per cycle, centered around the reference electron ER. Centered around the reference electron ER. As explained earlier, what is the optimum transition time? The optimum transit time should be capital T is equal to m plus 3 by 4. So we have to maintain this condition to make sustained oscillation. If n is equal to 0, it will become 3 by 4 cycle. If you keep it 1, it will become 1 3 by 4 cycle. If you keep 2, it will become 2 3 by 4 cycle. Like that, we have to maintain this condition in order to make sustained oscillations. Okay, now, so in this modes, 1 3 by 4 mode is the dominant mode. Why? Because this mode generates maximum power and it also has very high efficiency. This mode has very high efficiency. Therefore, 1 3 by 4 mode is the dominant mode in reflex crystal. Finally, it is a low power generator which generates powers in the range of 10 to 500 milliwatts output at a frequency range of, what is the frequency range? It can generate 1 to 25 gigahertz at a power output of 10 to 500 milliwatts. The efficiency is about 20 to 30%. The efficiency, the conversion efficiency of DC power to AC power is 20 to 30%. Finally, we will see the applications in laboratory. For microwave measurements, we can use reflex klystron. In microwave receivers, we can use this reflex klystron as local oscillators. For commercial purposes, military purposes, airborne Doppler radars and missiles, we can use it as local oscillator. So this is what about the operation of reflex klystron and its applicable diagram. So very, very important question in the examination. Thank you.